Reverend Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see. Helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked how? Why? I want the wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up the side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. Cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. Then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Interview 2, Reverend Delbert Winters.
smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two? It sure is great to see living human beings again. Volunteer, if you need supplies, Bob's got you covered.
Hi. Dasa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old.
If you're here to
I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. Terminals. The bombs and messed up people and the cows with two heads and all of it. Bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs.
It sure is great.
I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles and put new Coca-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything.
With smarts and a little luck.
Because my dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen.
Out there.
I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dawson said I can help collect food and water, so I'm getting better. I promise. And, Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now. Okay.
That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. Sure is great to see living human beings again. Testing those water samples? Smart move. Just fine out there.
Another successful message to him. When's the next one? I no longer require assistance. Please leave me be while I await further instructions.